Dear honorable viewers, all the students of class 6 and their parents, assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah. Welcome to the assignment solution for 2022 5th week. Subjects of this week are mathematics and science, and today's topic is mathematics. If you already subscribed in my channel, thank you very much. If not, please subscribe now to get the notification of next video, and that will inspire me for the next video development. For this, click on the subscribe button below the video, then click on the bell icon, and then click on the option all. Let's see the instruction for the assignment. Guidelines for the assignment. Read the following story attentively. Samir and Kamal are two friends. They decided to build their own houses themselves. Therefore, both of them went separately to Brickfield and Sandhill and a rod cement factory. Samir bought 15,000 number one bricks, 80 sacks of cement at 550 taka per sack, and high quality rod and cement as per necessity. On the other hand, Kamal bought 17,000 number two bricks with 15% discount, 80 sacks of cement at 450 taka per sack, and low quality rods and cement as per need. Number 1 and number 2 defines the quality of bricks. In a mixture of 800 kg, Samir used sand and cement in a ratio of 5:1 while building the house. On the contrary, Kamal used sand and cement in a ratio of 9:1 in the same amount of mixture. Watching the mixture, Samir told Kamal, "You are using less amount of cement in the mixture, my friend." After a few years of building the houses, the condition of Kamal's house deteriorated, whereas the house of Samir remained the same. At that time, Kamal realized his mistake. What do we mean by 15%? Express 15% in decimal fraction. Determine the ratio by taking the number of bricks bought by Samir as antecedent and the number of bricks bought by Kamal as subsequent. Determine the inverse ratio of the obtained ratio. Determine the equivalent ratio of the total price of cement bought by Samir and Kamal. Determine whether the obtained ratio is a ratio of greater inequality or ratio of lesser inequality. Determine the amount of sand and cement in the mixture made by Kamal. Whose house is durable? Explain. Indicator. What do you mean by 15%? Express it in decimal fractions. Determine the simple and inverse ratio of the amount of bricks bought by Samir and Kamal. Determination of the total price of cement bought by Samir and Kamal, and justification of the ratio of greater inequality. Determine the amount of sand and cement in the mixture used in the houses of Samir and Kamal. Justification of the durability of both the houses. Title of the assignment: Determination of Ratio and Percentage from a History, assignment number 2. From here, you have to start your assignment. Answer to the question number A. 15% means 15 out of 10. Out of 100. 15% means 15 out of 100. 15% is equal to 15 by 100. Your numerator is 15 and denominator is 100. Whereas the denominator is 100, so the decimal fraction will be 0.15. In the denominator, we see 0, there are two zeros. So, we have to place the decimal sign after two numbers from right hand side. I mean from right, after two number we have to place decimal sign. So here 15% is equal to 0.15. Answer to the question number B. Number of bricks purchased by Samir is equal to 15,000. Therefore, antecedent is equal to 15,000. Number of bricks purchased by Kamal is equal to 17,000. Therefore, subsequent is equal to 17,000. Therefore, antecedent is to subsequent equal to 15,000 is to 17,000 equal to 15 is to 17. Here, I have divided both antecedent and subsequent by 1000. Now, the inverse ratio of 15 is to 17 is equal to 17 is to 15. Answer to the question number C. Price of 80 sacks of cement purchased by Samir is equal to 80 into 550 taka is equal to 44,000 taka. Price of 80 sacks of cement purchased by Kamal is equal to 80 into 450 taka is equal to 36,000 taka. Therefore, the ratio of price of cement purchased by them is equal to 44,000 is to 36,000 equal to 11 is to 9. Here, I have divided both antecedent and subsequent by 4,000. We know that if the antecedent of the ratio is greater than the subsequent, it is called the ratio of greater inequality. Here, in the ratio, antecedent is greater than subsequent. Therefore, the obtained ratio is the ratio of greater inequality. Answer to the question number D. The ratio of sand and cement in the mixture used in Samir's house is equal to 5:1. The sum of the ratios is equal to 5 plus 1 equal to 6. Therefore, the amount of sand is equal to 5/6 of 800 kg. Here, if we divide 800/6, then the result will be 133.33333 to infinity. And then the result is 133.33. Here I have used only two numbers before the decimal sign. 133.33 into 5 kg is equal to 666.65 kg. Here, obtained amount of sand is equal to 666.65 6.5 kg. Therefore, the amount of cement is equal to 800 minus 666.65 kg is equal to 133.35 kg. Again, the ratio of sand and cement in the mixture used in Kamal's house is equal to 9:1. Therefore, sum of the ratio is equal to 9 plus 1 equal to 10. Therefore, amount of sand is equal to 9 by 10 of 100 kg. Here, if I divide 800 by 10, then the result will be 80. So in the second line we can write 80 into 9 kg and the total amount of sand will be 720 kg. Here I have multiplied 80 and 9. 720 kg. Therefore, amount of cement is equal to 800 minus 720 kg is equal to 80 kg. Answer to the question number E. The ratio of sand and cement in the mixer used in Samir's house is equal to 5:1. Therefore, sum of ratio is equal to 5 plus 1 equal to 6. Therefore, percentage of cement in total mixture is equal to 1 by 6 into 100. Is equal to 16.67%. The actual result is 16.66666 to infinity. But here I have used only two numbers before the decimal point, I mean decimal sign, and here I have added one number to the second number, and that is 6 plus 1, and the result is 6.7. Here the percentage of cement of total mixture is equal to 16.67%. The ratio of sand and cement in the mixture used in Samir's house, it will be Kamal. Kamal's house is equal to 9:1. Therefore, sum of the ratio is equal to 9 plus 1 is equal to 10. Therefore, percentage of cement in total mixture is equal to 1 by 10 into 100%. Here, if I divide 100 by 10, then the result will be 10, and the percentage of cement in total mixture will be 10%. Here, look very carefully. The percentage of cement in the total mixture of Samir's house is 16.67%, and the percentage of cement in total mixture of Kamal's house is only 10%, and 10% it is smaller than Samir's house. Here 16.67% is equal to is greater than 10%. Therefore, Samir's house is sustainable. Thank you very much for watching, and keep watching for the next video. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah.